Biomedical informatics is the large intersection of medicine, life sciences, and computation. We've just invested as a society billions of dollars implementing healthcare automation, electronic medical records. Medicine, which is a knowledge processing business, is going to be transformed by the ability for young investigators to mash up all this data together and see clearly the human being and the way that they're at risk or having a disease and what's the right therapy for them.
Quantitative background is very, very important for folks who work in this field. We are collecting enormous amounts of data that need to be analyzed.
But what we want to add that is different is people who are outside that traditional box, who can see the value in bringing new perspective to what we're trying to do.
Everything about healthcare looks dramatically different from the customization, the personalization that we see in any other industry. Netflix knows more about you than any doctor possibly could. We have to bring knowledge back to the point of care.
I do think that it's a natural thing for people working in health nowadays to reach out to people who understand large data sets. It's imperative for us to find ways of understanding it using computing.
With the data visualization, we can look at the data, we can try to sort of get a basic idea of, you know, how much noise there is, how it might affect the signal. And once we have that, then I would start thinking about, you know, what are exactly the questions we're trying to ask?
What I hope for in our postdocs and our faculty is not merely to have good analytic chops, be asking questions that matter. It's really about unleashing creativity of bioinformaticians.
Is it really the same disease? So that would be a good question to ask, that electronic health records have a wealth of information in there. And if you can put that together with genomic information, you've gone very far.
Today, autism is treated more or less like it's a unitary disorder. But if you look at the molecular characteristics, for example, you see kids with a strong inflammatory phenotype or characteristic and a strong neurological phenotype or characteristic. If you look at the electronic medical record, you see three different groups of kids. These are three different diseases, just based on the electronic medical record, and two or three diseases just based on the molecular characteristics. Autism is certainly going to be four or five broad disease areas. So you can have individualized medicine by knowing where people fall in broad classes, and it's really, really going to be important that for these other diseases, we also target these sub-diseases. So the overall department is the Department of Biomedical Informatics. We're small, but we're gonna grow.
We're looking to change the healthcare system from the bottom up by engaging people, having them know about what their information is worth.
To be able to ask the questions that we really couldn't even ask a decade ago.
How can we best use this to improve health and disease status?
The future is about figuring out how we can best use data to help people live healthier lives.